In our previous video, we have derived the expression for induced EMF in transformer. Then we have seen turns ratio and KVA rating of transformer. Now, based on these terms, we will solve few numerical problems in this video. Now, before solving numerical problems, we will quickly revise the expressions for EMF equation, turns ratio, and KVA rating. So, first of all, EMF induced in primary, that is E1, it is equal to 4.44 F phi m N1. So, here F is frequency of supply, phi m is maximum value of flux in the core in Weber, and N1 is number of primary turns. Now similarly, E2, that is EMF induced in secondary, it is equal to 4.44 F phi m N2. Here N2 is number of turns of secondary. Then the transformation ratio, which is denoted by K, it is given by K is equal to N2 upon N1, or it is equal to E2 upon E1, or it is equal to V2 upon V1, or it is equal to I1 upon I2. Now we have seen that the transformer is always rated in VA or in KVA. So KVA rating of transformer is given by V1 I1 upon 1000, or it is equal to V2 I2 divided by 1000. And at full load, the output is equal to rated KVA. And therefore, the expressions for full load primary and secondary current, these can be written as full load primary current I1, it is equal to KVA into 1000 divided by V1. Similarly, full load secondary current I2, it is equal to KVA into 1000 divided by V2. So, for solving numerical problems on EMF equations, you have to remember all these expressions. Let us now solve example 1. So, a single phase 150 kVA transformer means here the rating of transformer, that is rated kVA, it is given as 150, and it is required to step down the voltage from 1000 volt to 500 volt at 50 hertz. Means here the type of transformer is stepped down. So, HV side voltage or primary voltage V1, it is equal to 1000 volt, and secondary voltage V2, it is equal to 500 volt at 50 hertz. Means here the frequency F, it is given as 50 hertz. So, frequency is 50 hertz. The cross-sectional area of the core is 625 centimeter square. So, cross-sectional area A of core is 625 centimeter square. Now, we need the area in meter square. So, it is equal to 625 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter square. And the maximum value of flux density, that is BM, it is equal to 1.25 Weber per meter square. So, BM, it is equal to 1.25 Weber per meter square. So, determine 1, the number of HV and LV turns. Means you have to calculate the number of turns of high voltage winding, that is N1, and number of turns of low voltage winding, that is N2. Then, the EMF per turn, that is E1 upon N1. Or it is also equal to E2 upon N2, and the primary and secondary full load currents, that is you have to calculate I1 and I2 at full load. Okay. So first of all, what is the maximum value of flux density? So B is nothing but B is equal to flux per unit area. So B is equal to phi upon A, means Bm is equal to phi m upon A, or phi m is equal to Bm into A. So the flux, maximum flux phi m, it is equal to Bm into A. Now Bm is given as 1.25, A is given as 625 into 10 raised to minus 4. So maximum value of flux in the core, it is 0.078 Weber. Now we can calculate N1 and N2. So first of all, we can use EMF equation of transformer on primary side, that is E1 is equal to V1, which is equal to 4.44 F5mN1. So here V1 is known, which is equal to 1000 volt, F is known, 50 hertz, phi m is calculated as 0.078, so unknown is N1, which can be calculated. So here N1, it is 1000 divided by 4.44 into 50 into 0.078, which is equal to 58 turns. So number of turns of primary, it is equal to 58. Now number of turns of secondary, to calculate the number of turns of secondary, you can use the expression E2 is equal to 4.44 F5mN2. So here all other quantities are known, only unknown is N2. Or you can use the expression for transformation ratio K. So K is equal to N2 upon N1, and it is also equal to V2 upon V1. And therefore N2 is equal to V2 upon V1 into N1. V2 upon V1 is 500 upon 1000 multiplied by N1, which is 58. And therefore N2 is equal to 29 turns. So N1 is 58 turns and N2 is 29 turns. Now EMF per turn, that is E1 upon N1, or it is also equal to E2 upon N2. So EMF per turn, E1 upon N1. Now here E1 is equal to 1000 volt and N1 is 58. So solving this, you will get EMF per turn as 17.24 volt. If you calculate E2 upon N2, it will be again 17.24 volt. Now finally, we have to calculate primary and secondary full load currents. So you know the expression for primary full load current I1, it is KVA into 1000 divided by V1. So here KVA is 150 multiplied by 1000 divided by V1, that is 1000. So full load primary current I1, it is 150 ampere. Now you can calculate secondary current I2 using again the transformation ratio K. That is K is equal to I1 upon I2, and K is also equal to V2 upon V1. So you know the values of V2 and V1, you know the current I1, you can calculate I2, or you can use the expression for full load secondary current I2. So full load secondary current I2, it is equal to KVA into 1000 divided by V2. So here KVA is 150 multiplied by 1000 divided by 500, so which is equal to 300 ampere. So I2 is 300 ampere and I1, it is 150 ampere. Let us solve one more example. A 100 KVA. So here rated KVA, it is given as 100. So rated KVA is 100. 1000 by 230 volt. So voltage on primary side V1, it is 1100 volt. Voltage on secondary side V2, it is equal to 230 volt. single phase transformer has 60 turns on the secondary. So secondary number of turns N2 are equal to 60. So calculate one, the number of primary turns. So you have to calculate number of primary turns, that is N1. Number of primary and secondary full load currents, that is I1 and I2 at full load, and the maximum value of core flux, that means you have to calculate phi m, maximum value of core flux. So first of all, let us calculate the number of primary turns. So number of secondary turns are given, voltage ratio is given. So using transformation ratio k, we can calculate the number of primary turns. So we know that k is equal to N2 upon N1, and it is also equal to V2 upon V1. So here V2, it is 230 volt, V1, it is 1100 volt, N2 is also given, N2 is given as 60 turns, so you can easily calculate N1. So here N1, it is equal to 1100 divided by 230 into 60, which is equal to 287 turns. So number of turns on primary side are 287. Then second answer which we have to determine, it is primary and secondary full load currents. So primary full load current I1, you know that it is KVA into 1000 divided by V1. So primary full load current I1, it is KVA, that is 100, into 1000 divided by V1, that is 1100. So if you solve this, you will get I1 as 90.9 ampere. Then secondary full load current, again I2 can be calculated using transformation ratio K or the expression for secondary full load current. So here secondary full load current I2, it is KVA into 1000 divided by V2. So 100 into 1000 divided by 230. So it is equal to 434.78. So this is full load secondary current. Then finally, we have to calculate phi m, maximum value of flux in the core. So it can be determined either by using the expression for induced EMF E1 or induced EMF E2. So we can use the expression for E1, or E1 is equal to V1, and it is equal to 4.44 F phi m N1. So here V1 is 1100, F is 50 Hertz, and N1, it is 287 turns. Only unknown is phi m, which can be calculated. So phi m is 1100 upon 4.44 into 50 into 287. So solving this, we will get phi m as 0.01726 Weber, or you can write it as 17.26 milli Weber. So phi m, that is maximum value of flux in the core, it is 17.26 milli Weber. So let us solve third example. The primary winding of 500 KVA means, again, the rated KVA, it is given as 500. Then 3300 by 400 volt transformer means V1, it is 3300 volt, and V2, it is 400 volt. Transformer has 800 turns, means primary winding has 800 turns, means N1 is equal to 800. Determine the number of secondary turns, means we have to determine N2. Then secondary full load current, that is we have to calculate I2 at full load, and the EMF per turn on primary and secondary side, means we have to calculate E1 upon N1 and E2 upon N2. So first of all, number of turns of secondary. So these can be calculated from the transformation ratio K. So K is equal to N2 by N1 and it is equal to V2 by V1. So V2 is known 400, V1 is known 3300 and N1 it is given, N1 is 800. So you can calculate N2. So N2 it is 400 upon 3300 multiplied by 800, which is equal to 97 turns. So number of turns of secondary are 97. Then secondary full load current. So secondary full load current I2, it is KVA, that is 500 into 1000 multiplied by 1000 divided by V2. So V2 is 400. So if you solve this, you will get full load secondary current I2 as 1250 ampere. So this is the magnitude of full load current I2. Then EMF per turn on primary and secondary side. So E1 upon N1, and it is also equal to E2 upon N2. So what is E1 upon N1? It is 3300 divided by N1. N1 is 800. So if you solve this, it is 4.125 volt per turn. So EMF per turn, it is 4.125 volt. So if you calculate E2 upon N2, it will be also equal to 4.125 volt per turn. In this video, we have solved few numerical problems on EMF equation of transformer. In our next video, we will see the meaning of ideal transformer, the features or characteristics of an ideal transformer, and its phasor diagram. The link to download this presentation is provided in the description box. Thank you.